I'll be right
back. Well, Nick Aldis did the magic with this man walking out here and signing him to SmackDown. Fingers crossed he can do the same with Jake Cargill.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 250 pounds, Bron Breakker!
Quite simply put, bad news, Bron Breakker is intensity personified. You want to talk about a white-knuckle competitor? Look no further than this genetic freak. Oh, Bron, not this other genetic freak, Xyon Quinn, who has made some waves in NXT. And if you're Xyon Quinn, what are you looking to do tonight? What are you looking to accomplish against a stud like Bron Breakker?
To me, Xyon Quinn is someone who's bounced around NXT, Raw, SmackDown for the last few years. Prototypically, he has everything to make himself a major star in this game. And if you want to make it happen, Xyon Quinn, disrupting this man, Bron Breakker, is the fastest way you can do it. Easier said than...
Oh! Oh! Right out of the gate with a spear! And that's it!
Woo-hoo-hoo. Here is your winner, Bron Breakker!
My God! Hey, Wade, what do you say we watch the entire match over again?
Do we have enough time? Hell yeah, we do! Boom! It's over! Already 250 pounds of walking gel ignite. Simply do not strike a match when Bron Breakker is in town. I'll tell you this, Corey Graves. It's now 2 weeks into the run of Bron Breakker here on SmackDown. I'm already beginning to question who on earth will be able to stop him.
One spear, one win. Bright future, no doubt, for Bron Breakker. But I want to change gears again. We saw a few moments ago the disintegration of Damage Control, a faction that once ran roughshod over Friday Night SmackDown. They aren't the only faction that's been divided in recent times.